Here's some images from the recent shoot at Lamington National Park. Quite often, I'm going to use ISOs like 200, 400 ISO. Occasionally, I might even use something like 1600 ISO. What is rare to use is something like 12,800 ISO or 10,000 ISO. And the reason for that is noise, grain, and a lack of sharpness or definition to your subject. Let's see what we can do by processing in Lightroom Classic and then going into Topaz Photo AI a step further. Will it make a big difference? For this particular image, I'm going to first of all come to my preset, which is Vibrance New. So this is a preset I made, which is really simple. In the basic panel, you'll see here, it's just changed contrast, vibrance, shadows, and if we come down to detail, it's sharpened the image just a little bit. One thing I am going to add to this is masking. So I'm going to click on the Option or Alt key. I'm going to slide it across and you'll see when it's pure white, all the pixels are sharpened. As I go across, white defines the area of sharpened pixels and black are not sharpened pixels. So I've targeted my sharpening to the bird in this case. I'm going to go to the crop tool and just balance up the position of the bird to some degree. And I'm going to put it about there like that. If we now go in and look at 100%, you'll see that it's a little bit better than original. It's a little bit sharper, little less noise, but it's still noisy and still not sharp enough to my liking. Remember, we're 10,000 ISO. Normally, I would not consider processing and using this image because of the high ISO rating. I'm going to go to Photo, Edit In, Topaz Photo AI. So I have Photoshop capability there. I don't use Photoshop so much anymore, mainly for layers and that type of work. This, though, I think is a game changer. It takes me into this panel, and I've got a little drop box here of information. Now, this is important that you set this up from day one. I want the highest quality, which is TIFF. It's the best thing next to a RAW file. Pro Photo RGB, 16-bit, not 8-bit. I will use 8-bit as the final export quality for magazine use and that sort of thing. But my bit depth information while I'm working, 16-bit is fantastic, and 300 DPI or PPI. I click Edit, and it will now open up this image into Topaz Photo AI. Now, this time, my computer's already doing a little bit of hard work. I don't know if you can hear it in the background there, but that's because this is a very computer-hungry program. So it uses a lot of RAM. It needs a very good CPU unit. So if you've got an older computer, you might find this program or app difficult to do the work and or slow. So you can see there, it's already processed and done a preview for me. Have a look at the difference there, the noise and grain, the sharpness compared to this here. And that's on the autopilot setting. So it's done everything automatically for me. Now, of interest, I can manually control noise. I can actually go in and sharpen my image. So at the moment, it hasn't sharpened the image at all. I've clicked on sharpen and it's now reprocessing that image to sharpen it up just a little more. And have a look at the difference. An amazing difference there. And finally, I can come down and again control sharpness. And then finally, I can come down and actually upscale the image as well. So because this is already a lot of information, I'm not going to bother doing that, but I could go much larger with this file. In this case, I'm happy with the autopilot. I'm going to leave it at that. I click save, and this is where it can take a bit of time. So as I mentioned, my fan and my laptop's already doing a bit of work. You might hear it in the background there. It's now processing, and it will take a little bit of time to do that as a TIFF file at that resolution. So we're now back into Adobe Lightroom Classic. Here's the original DNG file, and here is the new file. So let's look at the two together. If we go back to the original DNG, I'm going to zoom in and look at the 100% Normally I look at my images at 50% because that gives a true representation of how they will look when they print. But of course, I'm trying to look at a little bit more detail to see how well this is processed or not. So there you go, there's the original DNG file. And here is the new version. And look at that, there's no noise and it's a sharper image. So back to DNG, grain, noise, sharpness is reasonable, but not fantastic. Now, no grain, no noise, and a sharper image. So now I can actually come in and finish processing my image. So I'll go back to basic, I'll go to shadows, I'll lighten up, and you can see there, I've done a universal lightening, but I'm not going to do that. I'm actually going to go up to my masking tool. I'm going to click on subject. It's going to target the bird. I'm going to up the exposure just a tiny bit and more detail into the feather area. See that there? Okay, so I'm going to go to about there and I might just do a little bit of minus highlights to lose that clipping in the red channel there. So I'm going to go minus highlights and you'll see the yellow actually looks a little bit deeper and nicer as well. I'm going to stop at that. Click the mask again, go in and have a look, love it, go F for full frame. Look at that, what a great result.